Chapter 6. Apparently, we have to find a lot of things for the final trial, so let's get to it. Namely, the secret hidey hole in... Hey, Kyoko. I may as well not have even had been in the room. Her gaze was fixed on only one thing. A present. Wrapped and covered with such joy. That's what made it so unusual. Oh, look at that. Papa loved her. But Papa was probably blackmailed. And she was left out of the loop. Better check out that suspicious present before I do anything. There's a brightly colored box here. It seems totally out of place in here. The more I look at it, the more suspicious I get. Could we open it? I'm getting kind of bad vibe from it. But I mean, can't not open it. Okay.
Makoto.
Be careful. Why, you think it's dangerous? No, not dangerous. But surprising, probably.
It would seem...
If it is what I think it is, at the very least, it's not something you'll be happy to see. Wait, so you know what's in there?
Anyway...
Just don't scream or anything, okay? It's probably like my dad's rotting corpse head. Are you saying it's something that'll make me want to scream? Okay, I'm gonna go open it. Makoto, it's probably your present. Step by heavy step, I approached the box. I took a deep breath and took hold of the lid. Slowly, ever slowly, I lifted it up. Light began to sneak its way into the box. Stole a hesitant glance inside and... Yoko's vice was no use. Let out a trembling cry. What was in the box? It was bones. Human bones. It's the last thing I expected to find in such a bright, joyful box. I mean, who could have possibly imagined? Apparently, Yoko has a very morbid sense of humor. Just as I thought. What? You wanna talk about that? I mean, just as you thought. I mean, how could you have known that? I mean, there were bones in there. Human bones.
Wrong.
Bones, I say. Bones. Well, it's not that I was thinking of the bones specifically. I just had a feeling it would be his body. That's pretty much the same thing. A dead guy in a box is still a dead guy in a box. Whether there's a little bit of meat on the bone don't matter.
My dosa.
Huh? What about him?
Correct.
What you found in the box. He's Papa. Those bones. That body. That's my father. You want to know why? I've seen that jawline before. Or at least what's left of him. So, clearly he was bludgeoned to death. Are you serious? This is Kyoko's dad. Same man she's been searching for. So, you wanna talk to him? I can give you like a minute. I love how Makoto's freaking the hell out right now. When we nearly died yesterday... Yeah. Hold on. How can you know that for sure? How do you know that's him?
So...
Given all the information we have already, it's the only possible answer. Right. Yeah, already got that. Yep. Yep. Mm-hmm. Killing game. Yep, I got it. Alter Ego said that the headmaster was probably here in the school. I love how they do a flashback, but at the same time, do a conversational flashback in the conversation itself. Anime! But the only ones who were alive... Dipper, hey buddy, morning. At the start of the killing game were us 16 students. When you put those two ideas together, it doesn't take much to assume...
In other words...
That most likely my father was in this school and he was also dead. Okay. Kyoko, I hate to really nail this home, but if your dad had actually been alive during the game and had been recently killed... Unless the bones were used, like a chemical was used to remove the sinew, flesh, muscle, you know, all the excess bits. And then the bones were cleaned and then bleached. That's the only way that would work. Yeah, like, the bones are too clean. That's my assumption, anyway. As Kyoko explained her analysis, she was completely calm. Or, no, she wasn't calm. She was trying to seem calm. She said it was just as she thought, so she knew it was a possibility. Or Monokuma ate him, yeah. Finger looking good, by the way. But I have to believe that at some point she wanted to be proven wrong. Which is why she never looked in the box herself, even though she had plenty of chances. I know Kyoko said she wanted to see her father so she could cut off all ties, but was that all there was to it? What a thrill, chat. The darkness is ever looming. What a thrill. Would she really give up her pride just for that? I couldn't help but wonder. Noice! You found a dead body! Noice! This picture. Oh, Kyoko actually did have a smile that's much larger than she normally has. It's all faded. Must be pretty old. Wait, is this a picture of a... Hey, Kyoko. How does she... Okay, for somebody who's really good at examining the room, she misses out on, like, the most obvious things.
Why would you...
Well, this is annoying. He came to cut myself free of the past, and yet... Telling me that he missed me this whole time? Papa! Now find something like this. What do you expect me to do now? Well, I expect you to resolve your issues before we go into a trial, because... Guess what? Then I have to. And I was right. It's a picture of Kyoko when she was a little girl. I mean, the hair does match. The smile, though... And I don't think she could actually smile that much. Not possible. Not possible. She was born the way she is. Knowing the headmaster had this picture all this time. Mister really cared about her.
Why?
But why have it like a hidden love? I wanted to face him and tell him myself to cut him out of my life for abandoning me. That's the whole reason I came here. Now he's abandoned me again. Okay, you cannot fault the man for being murdered. This time, he even stole the opportunity, the only opportunity I had to move on. Shame on him for getting murdered, really. I mean, some people, sometimes... Wait, like, somebody gets murdered that you know, just shame on them. Really, their fault. Yeah. Should have done better, should have known better. Exactly, Super. Should have known it was gonna happen. You know, obviously, should have avoided it, clearly. All his fault. Got beat to the head with something. Blunt force. Should have ducked. Yeah. Should have worn a helmet for his entire life. Has there ever been a worse father? Well, I mean... Did you see the RL Crafter trailer put in the DC? No, not yet. I saw it this morning. Yesterday, I happened to do a few things, so... Twilight Cabin seems like the kind of place you'd find a clue. I should take a closer look. I mean, there might be... A clue in the cabinet that has multiple spots? But I don't think Kyoko would like some stranger meat touching her dad's stuff. Okay, so she gonna have to touch it.
Hey.
It's fine. Check whatever you want. Are you sure? Oh, okay then. I went through each drawer one by one, starting from the top. What I found was piles of unrelated documents. Pretty dedicated to his job, huh?
Well?
It's just because he didn't have anything else. You know, she's ignoring... I love how... She's, for somebody who's so analytical, she's ignoring the fact that it might be that her father was forced to do this job. And her resentment towards him has some ground, but if it is a situation where he was keeping her safe, because why have her photo hidden in a secret room of all things? Show Tucker is the worst father. Show Tucker? Wait, is that his name? Any new things like 200 more structures, many more items, skill, and ability leveling system. He could have inherited our family business, our legacy. Instead, he left it all behind.
Now,
if he couldn't even handle a job like this, he would have been that much more of a failure. I'm sure he couldn't stand the thought of that and it made him desperate. Well, you are clear. Old Metal Alchemist. Yeah, a little bit. The headmaster's desk. Probably hiding some kind of clue, so I really want to check it out, but I really don't want to touch Kyoko's dad's desk without his permission.
Hey.
Don't worry about me. Feel free to look around as much as you like.
Because...
Never let anything get in the way of the investigation. I don't. Wait, my voice is robotic. It shouldn't be. Okay then. If you don't mind. Starting from the top, I opened all the desk drawers and looked inside. I rummaged through each one, finding nothing but unrelated documents. But in the last drawer, in case of emergency, and has a label on it, I found some kind of emergency handbook in the headmaster's desk.
In other words,
with no limitations given to the school's ultimate authority, the headmaster. I'm assuming that's what this is. I think you're probably right.
It would seem...
It might prove useful as we continue our investigation. Why don't you hold on to it?
I
don't need it. You don't want it. Go ahead and leave it here. Then I guess I'll take it. You okay? Ooh, I know where I'm going next yet.
Hey.
Listen, Makoto. Huh? Can I ask a favor?
So...
I know it's completely unreasonable to ask you this. And I know it's only inconvenience to that you that much more, but...
Hey.
Could you leave? Get out of here! Okay.
Correct.
Just for a little while, I'd just like to be alone for a bit. I want to reminisce with Dad's bones. Don't worry, I'm fine. I just need to calm down a little.
Just a second.
I need to get my emotions in order. Oh, okay. I feel like she's grooming to be a detective. Just a little bit, right? You know, Kyoko, you told me before about the relationship you had with your dad. How you were the only connected by blood, not by heart and soul. But maybe that picture motivated him. Maybe he had hoped to see me again someday. Is that what you're going to say? If so, just a theory. Well, so is your, like, he abandoned me. That's a theory too, Buttercup. And this isn't an issue that can be settled with theories. The picture doesn't change the facts of what happened, what I went through. Yeah, you went through something. But maybe it was out of your father's control. So... I mean, you basically blame him for getting murdered, so, you know, Kyoko, That problem can't be solved so easily. You're right. Sorry.
Anyway...
Once I got myself under control, I'll return to the investigation immediately. Please, just give me some time to myself. Okay, I understand. Then, I'll see you later. Leave. Okay! Is she really okay? No, she's not! It must have been a complete shock to her. I mean, it was a shock to me. Them bones. Daddy bones. She has motions? I think maybe she goes from calm to mildly humor to unusually pissed. So I don't think there's happy in there anymore. Wait, did you remember to take your essential bat oils? No, I didn't. There's no doubt the mastermind performed that evil deed. They killed the headmaster, killed Kyoko's father. They killed him. He's dead. Yes, Makoto, we get that, Butter. We'll leave hopes that... it was hopes... yeah, right. So, kill him to get control in his late 30s, right? Somewhere in this school. Wait, in his late 30s? Hold on. If he's in his late 30s, he would have had to have Kyoko, what, like 17, 18? Because she's, what, almost 20? But we were wrong about that. The headmaster wasn't the mastermind, which means that the mastermind's true identity is still unknown. But we know it's a school student. High school student. It's a cool student. Well, I'm still trying to wake up, chat. And this killing game began with 16 participants. All of them high school students. And only people take a single step in hope speaking since the killing game began. Are those 16 students? 15 of us met in the mall mail hall. Add Mukuro to the mix and you get 16. That's how math works. Including me, only 6 of us are still alive. Everyone else is dead. Well, even Mukuro, she's undeniably dead. I mean, gut wound tends to be pretty lethal. So the ones still left alive are me, Togami, Hiro, Toko, Ina, Kyoko. Only those 6 people are still alive. I love how the game's like, remember, only those 6. It's like, unless somebody faked their death. Then there's no question. Wait, no, that can't be. I refuse to believe it. There has to be some other way. There has to be. Okay, is that everything? Yep, okay. So now that we have the e-handbook, let's go ahead and run back to... It is over here. All right, let's see here. We have 3 working there, 4... All right, boom, boom, boom. Does that mean give it a try? No luck. Wait. Okay, yeah, Makoto. I sort of thought he would jump right to using the new handbook, but he's like, and I'm gonna use mine again. Smart boy, chat. Super, welcome back. Wait, but what about that emergency handbook I found in the headmaster's room? Okay, let's give it one more try. All right. What do we got? We have... Wait. Is this Heroes? The locker's totally disorganized. Whoever it belongs to probably has organization problems in every part of their life. Crystal Ball? No, it can't be. There's no way he ever used this locker. It's just not possible. Is this a deck of playing cards? No, they're tarot cards. But wait, aren't those used for telling fortunes? It's just a coincidence, right? I mean, like... There's all kinds of textbooks and notebooks stacked up in no particular order. And dust every... Okay, I'm sorry. Wait a minute. Did we go to school, have an entire, like, year, then got knocked out, then had our memories wiped, then put into a death game because maybe the person that got bullied decided to do that as their, what, like, graduation party? I mean, that's like... It's like Harry minus getting set on fire. I have to assume whoever stuff this is, they didn't do a lot of studying. Not that I could really talk. Trying to act as casual and natural as possible, I picked up one of the notebooks I saw. But the moment I looked inside the notebook, any sense of easiness I may have had evaporated. Everybody's memory was completely wiped. There was no denying what I saw. Inside the notebook was written Yashihiro Hagakure. Hiro. The notebook has also contained a large number of notes for a variety of different classes. I mean, I'll be fair, with COVID-19, it's been kind of hard to track a day. But when you get laid off and you're still looking for work, but when you have like almost really no connection to the outside world here and there, like try to remember where the days go. A little on the tricky side, to be fair. Which would mean he attended classes here. No, that can't be possible. I mean, Hiro came to this school at the same time as the rest of us, right? I mean, I would not be against the idea that the mastermind is part of the MIB. I mean, an organization of secret unknown individuals. A talking robo bear. Could be like a small little alien inside. Hey, never know. I mean, there's talking pugs in certain anime. We're all sucked in this evil world. We never had the chance to take any classes. So, what is this notebook? Nice. let's do the other ones. Whoa. No. I took the emergency handbook, ran across the car reader, and beep. Open. Now let's see what's inside. Oh, I don't see anything that might be a clue. Oh, okay, sorry. I got too excited, chat. Okay, beep. Eh? Things practically empty. There's just one thing, some kind of pocketbook? I see a name written on it, so I can't say for sure whose is it, but there's some writing inside. It could be important. I don't like violating the owner's privacy, but I'd better take a look. Makoto! Dude! Stop feeling like I shouldn't check it. I'm going through their locker anyway. I shouldn't check it. Dude, if you screw this up, everybody gonna die. I feel like they might give you a pass. All right, it's cool. It looks like a girl's handwriting. Well, watch, it's Sayaka's book. Or it might be Toko. And all the letters are spaced out evenly, like whoever wrote them was measuring them.
That sounds like a Toko fit.
Whoever wrote this must have been really meticulous. Flipping through the pocketbook, but my hand froze when I got a certain page. I saw something familiar written there, words I'd heard before. There's a plan to turn Hope's Peak into a shelter and isolate the students here in a communal life. I decided to talk to the one who came up with the plan directly. It just so happens to be the headmaster and my father. Oh, it's Kyoko! He was willing to give me some more details regarding the plan. Here's what he said. The point is to keep our student prodigies safe, keep them as our hope for the future. Only their genius can overcome disaster, only their hope can overcome despair. For the future of our country, our world, it's... Oh my god, please tell me I'm not right, and like somehow the outside world is just like destroyed and we are a goddamn ark. If we are an ark... Oh crap, we're screwed. No! It's not an exaggeration to call this our final hope. Which, okay, this is a little side thing. I'm sorry, I keep hitting the pause button, I know. But like, really, when you think about it, why is it always the crazy people that get lumped in with like humanity's last hope? You ever notice that? Like Armageddon, The Core, Deep Impact, pick like a movie, Independence Day, where like somehow the crazies still find their way in. And it's like, how does that keep happening? Okay, sorry. Must isolate our superior youth from the corrupted world so to serve as a foundation for a new era. I mean, yeah, there is a correlation to the smarter a person is, they might have a social and or mental issue. But like, to go all the way off of the deep end and be like, all right, we're gonna kill everybody. He parked on a handicapped parking spot when responding to an emergency call. Wait. Doctor got fined because he parked on a hand... when responding to an emergency call. Really, Super? Huh, alright. Yeah, that's a fine line right there, to be really fair. Like, I would have just parked anywhere and then as close as possible and hopped out of the car, but... this is the only hope we have. This is the only hope we have. I hope that you'll be willing to go along with this plan. I hope. So, that's what my father had to say to me. As usual, he made a selfish decision without consulting anyone else. Can't imagine a worse father. The worst. This can't be true, can it? But I knew it was, and I knew exactly who the pocketbook belonged to. It couldn't be anyone else. But if this belongs to Kyoko, what was it doing in this locker? And what she wrote here completely contradicts what she had told me already. She says she hadn't seen her dad since he left when she was little. Is she lying? Or did she forget that bit too? I decided to talk to the one who came up with the plan directly. Wait, didn't I... Oh, I saw... It's like, wait a minute, did we just read this? What does this all mean? Quickly scanned the remaining pages of the notebook and must have been looking for something that would prove me wrong about this whole thing. But when I reached the last page, the question marks spinning through my mind just started spinning that much faster. The gerbil on the hamster wheel is slowly missing a beat and he's just stumbling, chat. His whole little furry body is going around in circles. He's just holding on for dear life. When I looked at it, like the rest of the pocketbook, the writing here was messy, disorganized, scrawled. Despair walks among us, and so we sur- I was reading that. What is this? What does it mean? I have no idea. How could this possibly make any sense? Okay, so we survive. There's a second despair? You are taking that as evidence, right? Like, you're not leaving it. The more I see, the less makes sense because these lockers, I mean, they had belonged to the previous students, right? Which is us, right? So why am I seeing this? Why are there things in the lockers that look like they belong to people here? A notebook that seems like it belongs to Hiro. A pocketbook that seems to belong to Kyoko. There has to be some kind of explanation. But if I want to find that out, I have to keep moving the investigation forward and I have to believe in everyone. And we have to keep opening up more lockers. Right? Nope. Don't see anything I couldn't have a clue. Okay. Three more here. Damn it. Okay. Those are all busted. Damn it. Okay, that's it. Well, that was enlightening. We check the bathroom now? Oh, big pile of rubble. Okay. No. Got there, and we got there. Awesome. Let's see. Save a life or look for a parking spot.
Hey, Makoto.
That does seem really weird, Super, to be really, really honest. Hey, Makoto, are you here to look around too? Is that what you're doing here?
Mm.
Yeah. I can't help but wonder what that about Monokuma's door.
Yeah.
So I figured All the doors to the school have been locked. That should be one too, right? But... though I couldn't bring myself to open it.
I mean...
it might explode, right? I mean, that really sucks, so... you open it!
You're gonna open it, you're telling you make me open shit with the wrong you.
Peanut, no offense, but like, you do realize when you want to go out to like try to investigate and be useful, and then you have one job, and the first job was guard duty, you screwed that up, and then you had another job, which is this, and you don't want to do it, it doesn't help. I'm sure she didn't mean it, but she made it sound like it was okay with me getting blown up. Sure, I mean, you know, you can die. You can die. Not like I've been carrying most of everyone in here through the fires of hell. Okay, so I guess I'll open it. Oh, wait! What? Let me take cover first. I don't want to get exploded. See, now I don't want to open the door. Like, I leave and be like, hey, Togami, have you checked the data center? You should probably check that out. I think there might be a door. And then just walk away and not let him say